we are closing. We keep getting closer and closer to lithium. Once we pass lithium, we're on to the Universal Rumble, baby. And I am hyped tonight here in Omaha, Nebraska. We're in the Midwest for some epic action here tonight, brought to you by Monday Night Mayhem. Oh man, this is going to be an epic show here in Omaha, and we're kicking things off big just like we did last week with the boss, the new current temporary general manager of Mayhem. This is going to be intense. Omaha, are you ready? Oh shit, and the boss is making his way down to the ring here. Like I said, he is our new Mayhem GM, and oh god damn it, he's wasting all my damn contract money here. Look at all that pyro. I wonder how the hell the owner's paying for this shit. No, who knows? He may not be. But nonetheless, the boss is making his way down to the ring here to kick off the show. What the fuck is he wearing? Well, how did I just now notice that? What the hell is he wearing? Looks like a Mayhem color themed suit this week. Hell's the boss get the money to get this suit? He needs to pay for my goddamn job up here on commentary. Holy hell. Oh, damn. Ow, my ears. Fans, please back up. This is ridiculous. Mayhem's not used to this shit. Well, then. God damn, even the people at the VIP table are scared.
Man, that was a lot of damn pyro. Too bad that will be the last time we get to see it, because unfortunately I've been told by John Cena that we can no longer fit it into the budget. But boy, do we have a show planned for tonight on Monday Night Mayhem in Omaha, Nebraska! Pentagon Jr. will go one-on-one with Seth Rollins.
It's Seth freaking Rollins!
Ahem.
Sorry, continue.
As I was saying, Pentagon Jr. will go one-on-one with Seth Rollins. Also, Chief Graham and Pentagon are not allowed to have any physical confrontation before their match at Lithium. And if either man chooses to ignore my orders, he will be suspended indefinitely. Finally, tonight's main event will be The New Day taking on Connection member Brody Lee and a partner of his choosing, because Dylan Harris is not cleared to compete after his encounter with Pentagon last Monday on Mayhem. Well, now that we've got that out of the way and we know what to expect for tonight, did everyone get their ACWF Christmas cards this year? What the hell?
I don't understand why Nitro's doing this. Why is he cutting off the boss? Are you freaking kidding me? Are you freaking kidding me, bro? Like really? He was just about to talk about my damn Christmas card. I never got one. What the fuck's up with that boss? But nonetheless, Nitro now has cut him off. Maybe Nitro didn't get one either. Maybe he's salty just like me, but why the hell's Nitro out here? Okay, guys, and we are back, and Nitro is apparently in action now, and he is awaiting his opponent. And oh God, you know the boss just set this one up right now. This is going to be a bit of punishment here for Nitro coming out and cutting off the boss. You know Nitro does not like the ACWF at all. That's pretty much been shown in the past. He came out and cut off the boss here tonight, disrespecting the boss. And now he's going to get the person who's not a man. He's a machine. And that is Brian Cage. Cage is going to look to decimate. I say decimate. He's going to look to destroy. Decimate, destroy, whatever the hell he wants to do to Nitro, he's going to be able to do it. The thing is, the fact of the matter, Cage is still a little banged up from that six-man ladder, but he is not going to show it here tonight, that's for sure. Cage refuses to show that he's banged up here tonight, not even wearing any bandages on his ribs, but dude, he took nasty falls on those ladders back at New Horizons. That's why we haven't seen the likes of Omar Robinson since then, or Falcon since Uprising. They're out right now. They're banged up. They're nursing injuries, if you will. Brian Cage, though, here tonight, I don't think he gives a fuck. Brian Cage, if he can knock off Nitro here tonight, he could get a huge... That's a huge boost, in my opinion. That could almost take him out of the Rising Star division, in my opinion. Once again, that doesn't matter. Because the boss is running shit right now, but when does my opinion ever matter? Fuck, last year the freaking owner was chewing me the fuck out, but nonetheless, oh, I think Nitro caught him! Wasn't sure what happened there. Nitro actually caught him though, man. Nitro, of course, got that bettership over Cage, obviously, but Cage just has the sheer force, power, agility, pretty much everything, although Nitro is the fastest superstar in the universe. I don't know how many times I have to stress that. He is the fastest motherfucker here. Not only on Mayhem, but on Wreckage, too. Nitro, the fastest person in UWA. So he can look to use that to his advantage, I would say. Of course, right up there with him would be Adam Page, but I'd say Nitro's just a tiny bit quicker than him. Oh, and now Cage gonna look to use his lucha ability. Cage with ridiculous lucha ability when he's freaking so goddamn huge, it is ridiculous. Now Nitro gonna target the arms of Cage. Someone that size. The vintage elbow there from Nitro. Nitro, of course, being the number one contender for Randy Orton's Universe Championship. That match will take place at Lithium. That is going to be intense, guys. Oh, and Nitro ducks the clothesline from Cage. Oh, what up? Oh, that body shot. Nitro just lays out Brian Cage there with the uppercuts to the stomach. Holy shit. No, Nitro trying to stay in this. Nitro, a former Universe Champion. No one can take that away from him, man. Cage, though, is just monstrous. And oh, God. Yeah, you know the boss did this one on purpose. He's wanting to beat the holy hell out. He's wanting Nitro to get the holy shit knocked out of him. Oh, God. Now Cage looking for that curb stomp. Oh. Jesus, Cage has laid out Nitro. Nitro is fucking reeling right now, man. Former Universe Champion Nitro is reeling thanks to Brian Cage. Oh, jeez. Fucking machine right now in firm control over Nitro. Now into the cover is Cage. He took a little bit too much time, though. Only a one. Mr. Cena throwing up the one. Oh, Mr. Cena, the badass ref of Mayhem. Now Brian Cage is going to lift up Nitro. Nitro with a counter. Oh, and Nitro just spears him off the freaking apron. Oh, my God. You know the crowd right now is firmly behind Nitro. Oh, big boot there from Brian Cage, though. The machine just leveled him. Now Cage went to follow up Nitro with an arm drag counter, though. Oh, went for that big side Harlem kick. Cage caught him, uppercut to the face. Oh, now Cage snapping off a Rana. Now Cage gonna look to follow up, boots the face of Nitro. Six count, seven. Nitro gonna counter, sends Cage back into the ring. Now Nitro slides back in after him. Nitro's caught Cage, I do believe. He's caught Cage. Oh, he was going for the small package driver. Cage able to counter. Oh, Cage went for the discus lariat. Nitro caught him. Single knee face buster. Oh, and now Nitro firing up here. Nitro is fired up, man. Oh, the bitch slap from Nitro to the machine. Oh, and he slaps him again. Oh, my God. Nitro knocks him to the outside. What the hell is... Oh, my God. Nitro. Nitro looking to fly, man. Oh, shit. Oh, my God. Nitro is fired up. You hear the crowd right now, all of them on their feet. The capacity crowd here in Omaha, Nebraska is on their feet, guys. This match is insane. Nitro lifts him up into a neck breaker. Oh, my God, and Nitro's laid himself out. Oh, my God. Looks like that took more out of Nitro than it did Cage, and now Cage is going to throw him back into the ring. There was very minimal space there between the barricade and the floor there, and I think that hurt Nitro. Cage practically landed on the barricade, though, and that discus lariat just killed Nitro, I'm pretty sure. No, Nitro's still alive. Shoulder tackle takedown from Nitro. Now Nitro, the Nitro Nightmare, gonna lift up Brian Cage. He's got him up on his feet. Oh my God, we haven't seen this yet this year. He's dialing up the 6-1 Nitro. Now into the cover. Nitro for the win. 1-2. No, Cage kicks out at 2. Oh, and Nitro just stomping on the face of the machine. Now Brian Cage shooting the legs and just taking Nitro's feet out from under him, man. Oh, God, now Cage off the ropes, clear across the ring, Lion Soul into the cover. 1-2. No, Nitro kicks out at dose. This is insane, guys. This is how you kick off freaking mayhem. We've still got our main event tonight, which is Tag Team Turmoil, the other semifinals for mayhem. Who is going to go on to face Alchemy? That's the big question. The winner of that match will face Alchemy next week, but now Cage with that deadlift, though. The strength from Brian Cage. He just deadlift powerbomb Nitro into the mat. Oh, God, Cage is not wasting time, guys. Oh, another discus lariat. Nitro sidesteps, spins him around. Was he? Oh, big sound bomb into the cover. 1-2. Cage kicks out at 2. This is intense, guys. Now Brian Cage gonna use his power and just throw Nitro over his back. Wait, Nitro counters on a jawbreaker. Now Nitro's caught him. Nitro's caught Cage. Oh, going for that side, rushing. Oh, and you see exactly where Cage is set up, guys. Nitro not gonna take advantage of it, though. No, instead he's gonna dial it up again. A second 6-1 Nitro. No! We're so close to Nashville right now, man. No, into the cover. 1-2. No! Cage kicks out of the second. Oh, and now Nitro mocking Randy Orton. He's mocking Orton. Nitro caught a Brian Cage. Oh, my God. Into the cover. 1-2-3. What? What? Nitro can't believe this. Oh, and he's called for it again. Oh, my God. Can we see this happen to Orton and Lithium? A second Nitro cutter into the cover. Mr. Cena. 1-2-3. What? What the fuck? Are you serious, bro? Oh, springboard leg drop. Oh, my God. How did Cage kick out? This machine is just livid, dude. Nitro! Nitro does not know what to do to put Cage away! Just seems as though he can't! And now he's using the pressure point! Now Nitro into the cover, can that do it? 1, 2, 3, the vintage pressure point win from Nitro! Oh my god, Nitro just made him pass out there, holy fucking hell! Holy fucking hell, was that an amazing match. Right there, Cage just leveling Nitro with that discus lariat. Right there on the 6-1 Nitro, that was only a 2. Holy shit, I just can't believe what we just seen, guys. Look at the taking out the legs there is Cage. And right here, the machine off the ropes with a lion salt clear across the ring into the cover, man. Mr. Cena only got to a 2, though, and Nitro is able to kick out. And then right there after the 2 Nitro cutters back-to-back, he just applied that pressure point. Nitro just making Brian Cage pass out. And just like that, Nitro was able to pick up the win. Oh, my God, but we just seen Brian Cage eat 2 Nitro cutters and kick out. What the hell is it going to take to put away Randy Orton with that cutter when Orton's already done it? When Orton's known for that. But then again, he has that extreme leg drop, though. We were born to race.
We were born to race. So what you know about sacrifice? When the lights go out, the price you pay when you're digging down. Skin of your teeth and a pain in your back. What you know about? What you know about that? Ride it off as criminal, a place to cast a stone. On and on, we carry on when one is not enough. We are the ones who are born to rise.
Okay, guys, we are back here on Mayhem, and we've got MJP, Mary Jane Powers, Casey Adams. They're both in the ring here. Mr. Cena gonna ring the bell. We're gonna get this underway. This match has gotten very personal as of late. Oh, these 4 women, MJP, Marcella Emerson, Casey Adams, and Kelly Carino have all been involved in this bit of rivalry here. It all started back in New Horizons when MJP would end up teaming up with Marcella. It would be the rookie with their coach. And a tag team match. MJP and Marcella would win the match via cheap occurrences in the match right there. And Casey Adams just dropping MJP. You see how angry she is. This is Kelly Carino's rookie right now. Casey Adams going one-on-one with Mary Jane Powers. MJP with that super kick to the face, though. MJP, of course, pinned Casey Adams in her debut at... Oh, jeez, and another big kick. She's just chopping her legs down like crazy. God damn. And now Casey Adams, fired up, man. She is just livid. Of course, Casey Adams from England. One of the Brits here in the women's division. And oh, that heel stomp there again. The curb stomp with the heel from Casey Adams. Very similar to Seth Rollins' curb stomp, but she uses the heel instead of the foot. No, a variation of Rollins' curb stomp, I should have said, I guess. Oh, kick to the stomach, knee to the face there from Casey. Now Casey with the follow-up. MJP going to sweep the legs, though. This is our 1 of 2 women's matches here tonight. Of course, later after this to come for the women, we have the number one contender, Michelle Mercedes, in action. Oh, and Casey Adams went for a springboard. MJP going to roll out the way. And now a nice arm drag overhead takeover from Casey Adams. Casey Adams right now in firm control, but MJP going to counter. Oh, nice back suplex. Of course, the boss tonight doing the right thing and banning both other competitors in this rivalry from the ring. And Casey Adams right there able to move out of the way of that springboard 450. Now sends MJP into the corner. MJP counters back elbow. Runs at her. Nice crucifix head scissors. Rana from MJP. Now where's Mary Jane going? Oh, it doesn't matter. She went to stomp her. Casey rolls out of the way. MJP now going to send Casey into the corner. Casey Man has had an impressive performance ever since debuting here on Mayhem. But MJP going to shut her up early. Ooh, only a one. Only a one. Now MJP with a drop kick to the back of Casey Adams. Casey Adams, of course, the punk rock chick out of the UK. MJP, on the other hand, from Maine. Oh, and now what? Oh! Casey Adams spiking her on her head there with a nice DDT. Now Casey gonna lift up MJP. We'll look to send her into the corner here. Oh God, and oh God, we've seen this. We've seen this that other week where Casey did this to Marcella, and she's gonna look to do it again. This big stomp. Of course, still to come tonight, guys, our main event as Casey just destroys MJP. Our main event tonight is Tag Team Turmoil. Dylan Harris right now is not cleared to compete tonight in that match as the connection is going up against. Wait, Casey Adams looking for something big here. Oh, rake to the eyes, and oh, she just did MJP's move. That's the same move that MJP used to finish off Casey Adams at New Horizons. Cover one, two, the rake of the eyes, but MJP kicks out. Brody Lee is going to have to find himself a tag team partner because Dylan Harris is not cleared to compete tonight. He's still banged up from last week against Pentagon Jr., who's also in action later tonight. He'll be going head-to-head with Seth freaking Rollins right after this. That is going to be intense. But nonetheless, Brody Lee's going to have to find himself a tag team partner to face the New Day in Tag Team Turmoil. That is our main event tonight. JP now going to lift up Casey Adams, going to send her into the corner. Of course, the winner of that match will go on to face Alchemy next week. The final week before the... It's very interesting there from MJP. Insult to injury there. One, two, no. MJP kicks out at two. Ooh, and there's a stomp to the back. Casey Adams now looking to go to the top here. Casey looking to fly. Oh, foot stomp to the stomach. Oh, MJP able to roll out of the way of that stomp. MJP catches her with a spinning roundhouse back kick. Now an elbow from Mary. Casey counters. Nice counter there from Casey Adams. Oh, Casey went for a big right. MJP counters with a forearm. Oh, another spinning back kick from MJP. They're just going strike for strike right now. Now Casey Adams sends MJP back into the corner. Oh, geez, she's got her on the middle rope here. Oh, God, going for that Orton-style backbreaker. No! Of course, Orton, our Universe champ, will go one-on-one with Nitro for his title at Lithium. That is going to be intense as hell. We just seen what Nitro could do earlier. Oh, and MJP kicks out too. We already know what Orton can do. That's very clear. Casey Adams now going to lift up MJP. Snap her down again. Casey Adams looking to get payback here on MJP for not only last week on Mary Mayhem, but also for clear back in New Horizons when she pinned Casey Adams in her debut match. Oh, now springboard off the top rope there. Nice moonsault. The athletic ability there of Casey Adams on full display. Oh, now Casey backing up into the corner. Looking for that running knee strike. Oh my God, MJP counters. Casey Adams' neck just went off the ropes there. Now MJP gonna look to follow that up, but Casey able to counter, sends MJP into the corner. This is getting super intense now. How's Casey even still moving though is the question. She's got her neck caught up on the rope. Oh, now just choking out Mary Jane. Casey Adams now dragging her out towards the center. He'll look to shoot the cover here. Mr. Cena into the count. Two. No. Mary Jane Powers kicks out at two. And now Casey with a stomp to the back. Casey Adams going to the middle rope. Oh. What is she looking for here? What is Casey going for here? Oh, God. Oh, 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 oh! Oh, my God. Ever so impressive there from Casey Adams. Now Casey backing him into the corner again. She's going to try it again. She's going to try it again. She's going for the knee strike again. Oh, MJP doesn't want to turn around here. Oh, God. And oh, that knee right to the head of Mary Jane Powers. Oh, man. Now into the cover. One, two, three. Just like that, Casey Adams gets the victory there. Running knee right to the head of MJP, and that'll do it right there. The big foot stomp early on from Casey. And she would drag her out, shoot the cover here. One, two. Mary Jane was able to kick out at two, though, and then, That's interesting. Casey able to get out predicament, though. And choking her out there on the ropes, and then finally here, this knee right to the face. Oh. Right to the mush there of MJP. And just like that, Casey Adams is picking up another big victory. Casey Adams just impressing everyone here, I would say. Very impressive there from Casey Adams. Now we move on to Rollins, Seth freaking Rollins, and Pentagon Jr., your Rising Star Champion. Okay, guys, and like I said, next match on the card features the man of the universe, the only man that matters in the universe, your former universe champion, the man at one time that slayed the Viper, the sadistic son of a bitch, Randy Orton. This is your wrestling god. This is Seth freaking Rollins. If that wasn't enough for you guys, Seth Rollins, like I said, a former Universe Champion, not only that, but a former two-time NXT Champion is Seth freaking Rollins. He's a former everything, man. Seth Rollins is the shit on Mayhem, and I mean that in the most good way possible. Nonetheless, Seth Rollins is going to look to prove it here tonight, though, because he's going 1-1 with the Rising Star Champion. That is the man with Cerro Miedo, the man who just two nights ago took the loss to Dean Ambrose on that Christmas Eve extravaganza over on Wreckage. The man with zero fear, the dangerous, ever dangerous, Pentagon Jr., El Cerro Miedo. And out here comes Pentagon Jr. We seen a banger earlier with Nitro going one-on-one with Brian Cage to kick off Mayhem. First bit of action after Nitro came out and cut off the ACWF boss, our current and temporary GM of Mayhem. Pentagon Jr. now going to look to go head-to-head. Pentagon was practically given everything back that he wanted by the boss. And that's the completely opposite of what the Mayhem GM was going to do. And I guess the boss didn't want to get his arm broken in half, though, like the Mayhem GM had to suffer. Pentagon Jr. is a dangerous man. If anyone knows that, it's Roman Reigns. If anyone knows that, it's someone like Scotty Vortex. Yeah, you remember him? No, me neither. Or someone like any of those guys that Pentagon's broken. Any of them. And I'm not talking about broken Matt Hardy, although he did break him too to get the Rising Star title. Like I said, guys, he's facing the wrestling god, though, in Seth freaking Rollins. And now these two gonna lock up. They're gonna tie up, man. This is gonna be a legit badass match right here. My opinion, this could have main evented the show. Seth freaking Rollins and your rising star champion, Pentagon Jr., El Cerro Miedo. And now Pentagon just working over the arm of Seth Rollins there. Seth freaking Rollins has to watch his arm, because he does not want Pentagon to get it. And that's exactly what Pentagon's doing here. Oh, geez. Oh, geez. No. Pentagon right away just working over the arm of Seth freaking Rollins. The good part is, though, Pentagon is not allowed to use that arm switch anymore. That has been banned, so Seth Rollins does not have to worry about his arm getting broken. But any of these other moves that Pentagon does could severely damage his arm and possibly get it close to being broken. It could possibly tear a tendon or anything in Rollins' arm, really, practically. So Rollins has to be careful due to that fact. And right there, a nice sleeper slam flashback there from Seth Rollins. Hopefully it was a flashback for Pentagon. Oh. Hopefully not one of those bad flashbacks for Pentagon, you know, kind of like where he lost the one title at Mania that we're not going to speak of anymore because that title blows. But now Pentagon right now going after that shoulder breaker. No! Right there you see Pentagon just not letting up. Pentagon is very vicious, man. That is probably the thing that he has going for him the most, is that he is cruel. And he has no mercy. He has zero fear. He does not give a fuck what he does to his opponent. And Rollins, I think, needs to realize that. And he needs to look to use his overall betterness over Pentagon. That's not even a word, but I'm going to use it there. Oh, and Rollins, they're going for some sort of cutter. Pentagon able to shove him off. Now Rollins going to pull Pentagon back in. Maybe he's going for a neck breaker there. Honestly, I don't know why Seth freaking Rollins would go for a cutter. Although maybe to mock the Universe Champion right now. That seems to be what a lot of people love to do that are in contention for that belt. Oh, now Rollins going to the outside, going for that springboard frog splash. Oh! Of course, that's the finisher of Women's Champion Jessica Almeida. Now Seth Rollins right into the cover right away. Two. Ooh, already a two. Pentagon still got to be banged up after all those matches. Rollins looking to take care of Pentagon here tonight, though. No, Pentagon not going to let him. That's pretty clear. Rollins doesn't give a fuck, though. Neither one of these guys are going to let each other win this one. That's what's going to make this so intriguing. Oh, and a big face plant from Rollins. Well, now Rollins off the ropes. Phoenix splash, springboard style. And now Rollins just choking out Pentagon Jr. That is why he is the man. That is why he is Seth freaking Rollins. Oh, now the roll through. Pentagon better duck. Super kick. I'm losing my freaking voice right now calling this show. Seth freaking Rollins now just looking to target that arm of Pentagon Jr. The man with Cerro Miedo right now is in trouble. Oh, leaping knee drop to the face of Pentagon. Oh, now Rollins. Rollins is calling him up. Maybe looking for a dead agree. Oh, that is exactly what he's going for, the dead agree. No, oh, dead agree to Pentagon Jr. Is that it? Does the man have the win here? One, two, no. Pentagon kicks out the dead agree. Dude, if Pentagon can knock off Seth freaking Rollins, that shows, that puts him in a position to where he could practically say that he is good enough to run after that Universe title. But now Rollins going to the top. Phoenix! Oh, but Pentagon able to roll out of the way! Oh, God, Rollins crashed hard there! Rollins crashed hard! Lucha Destroyer! Lucha Destroyer from Pentagon Jr. Seth Rollins able to kick him off, though. And now Rollins is firing up here. The hell is he doing? Now Pentagon to the counter arm drag. Now, oh God, Pentagon going right back over that arm. Oh! Jumping arm breaker there from Pentagon. Or jumping arm bar, I guess I should say. Pentagon going right back after that arm of Seth freaking Rollins. Now how much he likes to assault the arm of his opponents. Now Pentagon's calling him up. He's going for that package, and once again, it's not delivered by UPS, bitch! Oh! It's delivered by the Cerro Miedo industry! Now right into the cover, Mr. Cena. 1, 2, no! Seth freaking Rollins kicks out of the package! Well, these two warriors right now just going back and forth, and Rollins finally realizes he's not going to let Pentagon target his arm anymore! Pentagon counter sends Rollins over the ropes. On a big right hand from Pentagon Jr. The man with Cerro Miedo has just floored Rollins. Oh God, what is he doing now? Oh God. Oh, flying fist to the face from Pentagon. Oh my God, in the crowd right now. And I don't even know what to say anymore, guys. Shinbreaker from Pentagon Jr. on the outside. So the crowd's loving that they're back out here on the outside. It's kind of like how UWA started out last year. Well, they're just going to the outside every single match, man. So that makes things a lot more interesting. But Pentagon right now is just working over Rollins. 7 count. And Pentagon going to send Rollins back into the ring at a 7. Now the man with Cerro Miedo, what is he looking for here? Oh God, another Lucha Destroyer! And he's busted Rollins open. That is not good. That is not good for Seth freaking Rollins. Rollins has been busted the fuck open. Oh, come on, Pentagon! Mr. Cena! Oh, Rollins kicks out! Rollins kicks out! How? How did Rollins kick out? Oh God, look at that buckle. STO! It's Seth freaking Rollins. Oh, now Rollins dragging Pentagon out towards the center into the cover. Can Rollins do it? 1, 2. Pentagon kicks out at 2. Of course, not to mention, guys, the ACWF boss has banned Chief Graham from coming out here again tonight. He has banned all contact between Pentagon Jr. and Chief Graham up until Lithium. They are not allowed to get in each other's way or do any sort of physical contact with one another. And now Seth Rollins has called up Pentagon, maybe looking for that knee strike. Oh, geez. Oh, knee right to the head of Pentagon Jr. Oh, and now Rollins. Rollins looking to put away the Rising Star champ. Can he do it? A second dead degree! A second dead degree! No! And Seth freaking Rollins has just laid out the Rising Star champ! Does he have it? Roll him over! 1, 2, 3! And just like that, the man picks up the win here tonight in a hard-fought battle against the man with Cerro Miedo, Pentagon Jr. Seth freaking Rollins with the win. Right there, the first dead degree, the 1 of 2. Of course, let's check this again. Pentagon would kick out of the first dead degree. Not a 3. Then right here, the Lucha Destroyer. I believe that was the 1st of 2. And then right there, he'd follow up with the package pile driver. Once again, bitch, that's not from UPS. Just like that, Pentagon thought he had the win. Rollins says no, kicks out at 2. And then right there, the second dead degree from the man, Seth freaking Rollins, would get him the victory. And just like that, the man of the universe walks out the victory over the Rising Star champion, Seth freaking Rollins, looking to get back on track here tonight. Okay, guys, and we are moving on to the next match on the card, which will be Michelle Mercedes back in action. And of course, we're going to take this time to advertise Lithium's headliner, but we will be right back with you guys in a moment.
We are the ones with the fire inside.
And guys, we are back as Jen Myers makes her way down to the ring. Of course, you guys seen that big match that's going to headline. Lithium is going to be insane. Randy Orton, Nitro, RKO, Nitro Cutter, which walks out on top. Of course, Jessica will defend her belt as well as Michelle Mercedes at Lithium. That should be interesting. Nonetheless, Mr. Cena going to ring the bell now. We're going to get this underway. Just as a huge opportunity for Jen Myers, but Michelle Mercedes is going to take none of it, as she just arm drags Jen right over the top of her to kick off the match. Oh, Michelle has definitely shown her true colors as of late. She's not a nice person. And now Jen counters with a knee lift. Of course, Michelle Mercedes, the veteran wrestler out of Texas. Jen Myers, another UK competitor here on Mayhem. No, out of Blackpool. Now Myers with the feet to the face of Michelle Mercedes. Neither of these women are very nice, and well, that's going to be displayed here, as you can already tell. And now Jen counters, sends Michelle into the corner, big knee lift. Oh, now Jen just kicking her. What the hell? Oh, God. No! That's right out of the playbook of a heavy metal rebel. Now Michelle Mercedes with a nice arm drag counter. Now Michelle gonna lift up Jen Myers. Oh, gosh, she's got her by the throat now. No! Oh, that vicious STO. Now Michelle going to the middle rope. She's gonna call up Jen. If you've seen any of Michelle's matches, you know what she's going for here. That blockbuster. Wait, no, she turned it around. Missile dropkick there from the middle rope from Michelle Mercedes. Guess she knew Jen probably had scouted and she switched up. That's the veteranship there of Michelle Mercedes on display. Now Michelle off the ropes. Axe handle. Jen was able to sidestep. Doesn't matter. Michelle stays in control. Ooh, and now the kicks. The kicks there from Michelle. Now Michelle is raking her boot across the face of Jen Myers. Jeez, Michelle is just manhandling Jen right now. One, only a one. Myers kicks out a one. Ooh, went for the knee in the back. Jen Myers able to sidestep. Ooh, but Michelle caught her. Jen counters. German suplex. Oh, now Jen Myers going up to the head of Michelle Mercedes. Jen going to look to shoot the cover here. Mr. Cena into the count. One. Oh. Barely a one. Michelle, if she doesn't have to, is not going to stay down for a two, it looks like. Not against Jen Myers, anyways. Jen Myers, of course, going to use her viciousness here to fight a little dirty. Ooh, and now just kick her over again. Guess that's one way you do things. Ooh, and now the boots to the face. Oh! Now Jen Myers is going to lift her up. Oh boy. No! Big sell. Spine buster there from Myers. Myers went to follow up. Michelle counters overhead kick. Michelle counters again. Jawbreaker. That's that veteranship once again. Ooh, big right hand. Backstabber from Michelle right into the cover. Could that be it? One, two. Jen kicks out at two. Oh, but Michelle's had enough. She's calling her up. Maybe looking for Mercedes Benz. That's exactly what she's going for. Oh! One, two, three. And just like that, Michelle Mercedes with the win. Michelle looking impressive here tonight. That didn't take too much, it seemed, to put away Jen. Of course, it's going to take a lot more than that to put away Jessica Almeida at Lithium, and if anyone knows that, it's Michelle Mercedes. I mean, that was pretty much made evident here tonight. Right there, Mercedes-Benz from Michelle Mercedes to end the match. Michelle's go-to finish. And was able to put away Jen Myers here tonight. Now the question is though, can Michelle Mercedes use that same move to put away Jessica Almeida at Lithium? Will Almeida once again pay tribute to Eddie Guerrero and hit that frog splash, Viva La Raza? I don't know, we'll figure out at Lithium. And up next, we have a point. We have a match for Rising Star points. I was beginning to think that the boss had forgot about the whole Rising Star points situation, you know. Since after Christmas Eve extravaganza, we now know Chief Graham will be going into Lithium to challenge Pentagon Jr. for the Rising Star Championship. He didn't earn points to get it. I'm hoping there's not any favoritism here from the boss, but it seems like it a little. Nonetheless, Chief Graham does have an issue to settle with Pentagon Jr. I don't know if he necessarily deserved the Rising Star title match, although he did defeat former champion Broken Matt Hardy on Christmas Eve extravaganza. Need to check that out because now Chief Graham is now the number one contender for Pentagon Jr. But here tonight, we've got a Rising Star points match nonetheless put together by the boss. So I guess maybe this will build towards the Rumble, towards our Universal Rumble, which is coming up here in about less than a month, actually. And who is his oh, geez. Okay, guys, this man got a contract last week. It is none other than El Hondero. Of course, Virgil accompanying him down to the ring here. El Hondero is set for one-on-one action here for Rising Star points, one-on-one with Dolph Ziggler. And they're going to try to get that fuck money, baby. But nonetheless, El Hondero is making his way down to the ring with Virgil. Well, as I was going to say at his side, but he's not really. Nonetheless, El Hondero going to try to pick up the points here. El Hondero, we've seen him in an impressive victory last week over Donovan Reiser on Merry Mayhem. That earned El Hondero the contract on Mayhem. And now Hondero running right at Ziggler. Oh, nice tilt-a-whirl arm drag. Hondero stepping his game up here tonight, guys. Arm drag counter from Ziggler as well. Smash is going to be very back and forth. Ziggler taking control, though. Snaps him down. Now looking for a bit of a neck snapper. Ooh. Oh, God. Ooh. That did not look pretty. Oh, now Ziggler going to the middle rope. The fuck is he doing? El Hondero getting up. What is Ziggler thinking? Oh, missile drop kick from the middle rope. Of course, guys, after this will be your main event tag team turmoil as Brody Lee found himself a tag team partner with the Connection. Of course, Dylan Harris is not cleared to compete tonight due to the amount of damage that he took from that pile driver on the outside last week. It's a good thing it was only snow that he landed on. Otherwise, it could have been a lot worse. Of course, that snow is part of the reason why Harris didn't do good at all in that match. He kept slipping on the snow out there. His boots did not catch any traction in that match. On Ziggler with a counter jawbreaker now. Float over, snap DDT from Ziggler. Now Ziggler putting in that work, locking in that cross arm breaker. El Hondero fighting out. El Hondero fighting out. Shots to the face. El Hondero had a miracle of mayhem last week. Can he get another big miracle tonight, the night after Christmas? Oh, and Ziggler with a nice elbow drop. I'm surprised we were able to get our old arena back. After all that freaking pyro that was wasted on the boss's entrance, and that came out of our fucking budget. Surprised we were even able to afford our arena. Oh, now, an arm drag again. Tilt-a-whirl arm drag again from El Hondero. Ziggler counters, breaks it off with an uppercut. Now Ziggler, bionic elbow, the head of El Hondero. Now Virgil with the distraction. Mr. Cena, you gotta stop this shit. El Hondero with control, Northern Lights suplex to Ziggler. Now El Hondero off the ropes, went for a moonsault. Ziggler scouted it very early there. Went to kick him over, Hondero, oh! Hondero got caught into that big snap power slam. Ziggler into the cover, only a one. This is going to be intense. You know Ziggler wants to get back in that title picture. Oh. Ziggler trying to capture his first bit of gold here in the UWA. Now Ziggler. Oh, geez. Oh, no. 2, 3, 4, 5. He's going to kill El Hondero. 6, 7, 8, 9. The 10 elbow drops to the chest of El Hondero from Dolph Ziggler. Ziggler has really rocked El Hondero, and now he's calling him up. Oh God, maybe looking for some sweet chin music. No, El Hondero counters. Ziggler staying in control though, sends Hondero into the corner. He went to kick him in the stomach. Hondero catches the foot windmill kick. Now Hondero lifting up Ziggler. And what is Hondero doing? Standing C4. Oh! Oh God, and now Hondero. He has Ziggler set up in a perfect position here. Oh my God, Virgil's got to be loving this. Oh, time to get that fuck money, baby. Mr. Cena cover. 1, 2. No! Ziggler kicks out the frog splash. El Hondero's not done there, though. He's going back up top, maybe for another move. Oh, God, he's calling Ziggler up. The hell is El Hondero thinking? Oh, geez. Oh! This is why we shouldn't have gave him a contract. Oh, my God, he just botched that move. That did not look pretty. Now Hondero gonna stomp on him. Was he? Oh God, he's not. Is he rolling thunder? Oh! Now El Hondero into the cover. 1! Only a 1. El Hondero giving it his all here. Kick to the back of Ziggler. Don't forget two years ago, Ziggler main evented our biggest show of the year with Undertaker. Oh! He didn't main event it, but he was on that show with The Undertaker, competing for the streak at the time. And Dolph Ziggler kicks him off. Blood over. No, DDT, of course. Undertaker was defeated by El Diablo at that same show the following year. Last year, that is. Ziggler right back into a cross arm breaker on El Hondero. El Hondero could be forced to submit here. Is he going to have to tap out to Ziggler? Ziggler's got him in the cross arm breaker. This could be very bad for Hondero. Hondero able to fight out of it again, though. I thought he was going to tap. Oh, damn. Now they're squaring off face to face again. Ziggler's going to snap him down. Went to drop kick him in the back. Hondero sidesteps. Hondero running another tilt-a-whirl arm drag. Now El Hondero not wasting any time. Lifts him up. Oh, Ziggler counters. Sends him into the corner. Full speed stinger splash from Ziggler. And now Ziggler going to lift him up. On Ziggler with the famous El Hondero. Oh, geez. And now the boots to the face of El Hondero from Dolph Ziggler. And now Ziggler leaping elbow into the chest. Kip up. El Hondero right now is in serious trouble. Ziggler calling him up. He could be looking for the ending here. Zigzag! Oh man, he has laid out El Hondero. It's over. 1, 2, 3. And Ziggler just knocked off El Hondero. Dolph Ziggler now has 2 points towards the Rising Star title. Dolph Ziggler has now put himself back in a position to get gold finally again. That big frog splash from Hondero, he thought he had it there, and then a rolling thunder. El Hondero, there was many points there to where he thought he had it. But, you know, Ziggler just that much better than Reiser, and he was able to keep advantage long enough and throw off Virgil, and he got the win. Mr. Cena was not going to be fooled tonight. Dolph Ziggler, of course, had that submission locked in. If he would have got that, he would have got 3 points. But nonetheless, Ziggler with a pinfall win. That gets him 2 points. He's now in the lead with 2 points. Going towards the Universal Rumble. Okay, guys, it is now main event time. Time to figure out who the hell is going to go on to face Alchemy. That's the scary thing. One of these two teams has to face Alchemy. Coming out first, of course, is the returning New Day. The New Day had a match a couple weeks ago in Turmoil where they made their return and they took on the Young Bucks. Of course, we knocked them out in round one. Now, if they can knock off the tag champs, or one half the tag champs, Brody Lee here tonight, they will move on next week to face Alchemy in the finals on Mayhem. Of course, the finals of the whole tournament will be taking place at Lithium, where the final tag team left standing on Mayhem will face the final tag team left standing on Wreckage. The winner of that will be named Tag Team Turmoil Winner of the Year, the best tag team of the year. And the New Day are already celebrating ahead of time. I hope they realize if they win, even if they do somehow knock off Brody Lee, they're going to have to face Alchemy. But nonetheless, the winner, I mean, they have a decent chance right now considering the fact that Dylan Harris cannot compete tonight. He is not cleared to compete. So Brody Lee needs a partner, or he's going to have to go into a handicap match. Of course, Harris is going to be on the outside to support him, but that won't be enough. Brody Lee is going to need some serious help here. Now here, of course, comes the Bulldozer. Of course, being accompanied to the ring by diehard Dylan Harris. Harris not wearing his belt here tonight. Didn't even want to take time to come down here with the belt. How disappointed he is. Oh man, but nonetheless, DH. Dylan Harris is not happy. So like I said, I don't blame him. It sucks, dude, but I mean, if you're not cleared, you're not cleared. Oh God, what? Oh, Dylan Harris just stepping on Francesca. I think Harris gives a fuck, though. Fuck Francesca, right? Well, Brody Lee's coming down here without a partner. Of course, Eric Young right now out on injury. Looks like Brody Lee's going to have to go in and alone. Well, damn. Wait. Oh, my God. No way. What is Graham coming down here for? The hell? It's Chief Graham. Is Graham... No way. On no way did I ever expect someone to actually come out and help the Connection. Of course, you know, though, Graham has the same issue as the Connection does right now, though. And maybe Graham... I don't know. He realizes that Pentagon, I guess, took out Dylan Harris. But so I guess Graham's coming down here out of sorrow or sympathy for him? I don't know. They always say the people with this, how the fuck does that saying go? I don't know, but Graham's out here. The enemy of my enemy is my friend, and I guess that's how this works here for Chief Graham. Graham and The Connection both have issues with Pentagon Jr. right now, and it looks like Graham's coming out here to even the odds to help The Connection. I don't know, this is really weird. It was really weird seeing Graham in the corner of Brody Lee and The Connection over there, but like I said, Dylan Harris cannot compete tonight. And this is how turmoil starts off, and of course, Brody Lee's off his game right now, and Xavier Woods out there going to make sure. And, well, I'm surprised he's still able to play Francesca. Dylan Harris stepped on it. Nonetheless, guys, the winner of this will go on to face Alchemy next week in the finals. This is one half the tag champs and Brody Lee taking on the New Day with Chief Graham in his corner. So we'll have to see how Graham and Lee work together here. Can't imagine this going well at all. Not even a legit team, and they're facing the New Day for the kings of the triple teams. Oh, now he's going to send him off the ropes as Brody Lee. Kofi Kingston caught the arm, though, into a nice arm trap neck breaker. New Day have been on a roll as of late. Oh, and now Kofi going to the outside springboard. Oh. Springboard somersault into the ring. That did not work out well, though, for him. Ooh, and now Brody Lee tagging out. In comes the Chief. In comes Graham. He'll be going one-on-one with Pentagon Jr. at Lithium, and Kofi taking it right to Chief Graham as well. The New Day right now is in firm control of things. Oh, now Kofi gonna stomp on the arm of Chief Graham. Graham, or should I say Deviate Graham, with that freaking brace to the arm of Kofi. We see him use that brace like crazy against broken Matt Hardy. Not even sure if that's legal, but you know the boss isn't going to make him take it off. Oh, now, a gut buster there from Graham. Now Graham going to go after the arm. In all fairness, Pentagon did break that arm. I'm not sure if the arm's still fucked up, but nonetheless, using that brace again. Diving elbow to the chest. And Graham is fired up. Graham's just looking to take out all his pin-up darkness and anger out on Kofi here. Oh, and Graham able to shove him right off. Oh, and the brace to the face again. Xavier's now put down the trombone. He knows it's business time now. Elbow right across the face of Kofi again. The brace to the face again. Oh, God, now the brace to the back of the neck. He's just picking apart Kofi Kingston here. Oh, and here we go. Tribal kick. Now, Graham right into the cover. One. Ooh, Brody Lee was not able to get there and make stop Big E there. Now Kofi going to look to counter. Jawbreaker from Kofi. Kofi going to follow up. Set out Bichinoku driver to Chief Graham. And now Kofi starting the claps. New Day rocks. New Day rocks. And now Kofi going to send Chief Graham into the corner. The hell is Kofi doing? Kofi staring down Graham, and while he's fucked up now. Oh, no! The freaking Navajo neutralizer. And don't forget, guys, when Graham hits that, that's on that braced shoulder. One, two, no! Kofi kicks out somehow. I thought it was over there. Graham has just been completely annihilating Kofi Kingston right now. On Big E, you see him staring off of Brody Lee. Kofi able to counter knee lift. Kofi really needs to look to get out of the out of that match there. Oh, boot to the back again. Oh, now kick to the stomach. Kofi now getting out of harm's way here. Tag out. In comes Big E. Big E now the fresh man in the match. Oh, and Big E has Chief Graham up on his shoulders. Oh, maximum impact. Okay. That's really old school fatal there. Now right into the cover. Could that be it? The Maximum Impact one. Ooh, only a one. Of course, Big E does not do it as good as Fatal. Obviously. Oh, now Big E has Chief Graham up on his shoulders and just tosses him over. Big E gonna look to use the power game here against Chief Graham. Graham fighting him off though. And oh, elbow to the stomach of Big E. Oh, now Graham's caught in modified Russian leg sweep. Now Graham is not gonna let Big E go anywhere. Oh, and now targeting the leg of E. Kofi looking over to Xavier Woods. And we're not expecting this much of a fight here from these two. Navajo neck breaker from Chief Graham. Oh, now Brody Lee just looking to follow up where Graham left off. These two are working well together here tonight so far. Graham is doing a good job of working together with Brody Lee of the Connection here tonight. Oh, stomp to the stomach there from Lee to Big E. Oh, now stomp to the knee. Brody Lee now is just dissecting Big E. We're now gonna send him. Nope. Big E counters. Belly to belly. And now Big E has to try to remain in control here. He wants the New Day to get anywhere in this match, because so far the New Day have been getting annihilated here from Brody Lee and Chief Graham. Ooh, stomp to the face. Now Lee counters, shoots the legs of Big E. Oh, now another counter there from Big E. Big E with a shoulder tackle takedown to Brody Lee. These two are just going back and forth. One. Ooh, barely a one. I don't even know that if that was a one. The bulldozer. Oh, shit. Brody Lee is furious. And a running hurricanrana there from the big bulldozer. The fact that someone that size can do a hurricanrana is just insane. Now Big E once again looking to bore down the match here with this thing. This is why the New Day didn't keep contracts for long. Now Big E gonna lift up Brody Lee here. Oh, he's got him overhead, belly to belly toss from Big E. Now Brody Lee is in a bad predicament here. Brody Lee is in a seriously bad predicament. Of course, he doesn't have Dillon Harris to back him up here in this tag team match. Oh, God. And, well, here we go. The Unicorn Stampede is activated. Oh, geez. New Day rocks. 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 New Day. Oh! Jeez, and they just destroyed Brody Lee there with that Unicorn Stampede. One, two. Brody Lee able to kick out at two. Oh, now Brody fighting off Kofi. Oh, come on! Fuck you, Big E! Get out of here! You giant pussy. It's friggin' cheap as shit. Oh, now Kofi's stomping on him, gonna roll him over. The boom drop! The boom drop! No! Jeez, and now Kofi lifting up Brody Lee. Brody Lee gonna counter, sends Kofi over the ropes. Kofi now hung out on the ropes here. Brody Lee just staring him down, he needs to follow up. Oh, now Brody Lee running at him. Kofi able to leap over the back. Now Kofi sends Brody Lee into the corner. This is not good for the bulldozer. Brody Lee is in a serious predicament here. What the hell is Kofi doing? What the hell? Figured they're going for midnight hour there. No, Kofi, oh my God. No, shit. Well, Brody Lee's not getting up from that. The bulldozer has been bulldozed here tonight. Oh, geez. Brody Lee is just... Brody Lee's got to be out cold now. Now Kofi from the middle rope. Kofi now calling the bulldozer up again. Gotta be kidding me, Brody Lee. Oh, jeez, a hurricanrana from Kofi Kingston. Now Kofi lifting up the bulldozer. Oh, jeez, now Brody Lee thrown into the corner right where he doesn't want to be. Now the New Day just continuing to work over Brody Lee here. Oh! Brody Lee has been in a handicap match, it seems like, for quite some time here. Graham has not got tagged in a while. Graham was in complete control of this match then. Oh, and now the ref keeping control of this match here, stopping Graham from interfering. But, jeez, Big E with a fall-away slam off the top. Oh, but wait, Lee targeting the leg there. Graham exposed the leg of Big E earlier, and Brody Lee targeting it now. Oh, God, he's gone by the throat. Wait, Big E. Oh, come on, he raked the eyes. What the hell? Oh, and a clothesline. Gotta be kidding me, man. These guys are just cheating like crazy. This isn't even fair right now. It's only one half the connection in this match. Not even a real team. Now Big E into the cover. One, two, and Graham able to break it up again though. Oh, now Brody Lee shoving off Big E. He's to make the tag right now. Tag out, in comes the Chief. In comes Chief Graham. Oh, and Graham with the brace to the face of Big E. But Big E right there is just gaining control again. It's the superiority that these two have as a tag team. Oh, now the knee to the face of Chief Graham. Oh, now Big E. Oh, God, he is not. Oh, God, he's going to flatten Chief Graham. Oh, jeez. Ah! Oh, damn. Right into the cover. One, two. Graham kicks out at two. Chief Graham is staying alive in this one, but barely. I don't know how he is. German suplex from Big E. Big E tired and all right now, putting the work to Graham. Oh, God, and now Graham is in trouble. Graham is in trouble. Wait, what? Big E throws him into the corner. What the hell is Big E planning here out of the corner? Oh, God, Graham does not want to be there. Graham counters. Boot to the face from Chief Graham. Oh, Graham was firing up, but Big E caught him. Big E caught him. Oh, no. You've got to be kidding me. These fuckers are cheating. No. No. The New Day with the midnight hour. Ref completely out of position here. One, two, three, but the New Day wins. Oh my God, the New Day are moving on because they're cheating cock munchers. That is fucking bullshit. Big E has cheated this whole freaking thing, and what the fuck, Mr. Cena? They freaking had this match won. The connection were in perfect control of this match, well, Lee was. Then, oh, that maximum impact from Big E out of nowhere. This has got me irritated in some to some unknown explained level. And the fucking New Day just... this is bullshit. New Day nonetheless just knocked off the connection. Well, technically they knocked off Brody Lee and Chief Graham. But nonetheless, oh, on paper it'll say they knocked off the connection, even though they pinned Graham to do it. And just like that, the New Day are moving on to the finals on this mayhem side of things. Say I'm not happy is an understatement. I am fucking furious. These three clowns can go fuck themselves. hell is wrong with these faggots? God damn it. This is whack as fuck.